to notice that the abdominal swelling and after that for 10 days, which are the data we have investigated on the 31st August, that was admitted for Supalang Animal Hospital. For the physical examination on that day, that was depressed, have T new cut membrane CRT for 3 seconds, heart rate at 104 BPM, respiratory rate 60 BPM, lumen conduction rate 2 complete cycles in 2 minutes, body temperature at 105.6 degrees Fahrenheit, pharmacia score in the 2, in the score of 5, have 7% dehydration, heart sound and lung sound normal, body weight about 23 kg, body condition score CO5. On the palpation, we found that that got bilateral p-stimular lymph node enlargement. And on the mass at mental abdomen, there are well circumscribed and fluid feel like mass. And mental pain, there are no pain. For the mass, we can differential diagnosis as abscess, seroma, hematoma, cyst, hernia, and tumor due to the content inside the mass. For the initial plan, first at the farm, we decide to do abdominal ultrasound to determine what's inside the mass, and we'll do aspiration if needed, and then to the fluid analysis. After that, we brought back down back to the Pasupalang Animal Hospital and do abdominal radiography and blood examination to determine the health status. On the abdominal ultrasound, inside the mass, there are heterogeneous hyperhypogenic content and no reliable structural inside the mass. So we decide to do the fluid aspiration, and we can aspirate the dark yellow pelvic fluid have the festive odor. On the farm, we aspirate the fluid about half a liter, but there are still a lot more inside the mass. After that, we send the fluid to fluid analysis and the cell wall modified antidate with nemolus polymorphonic cell and coccus bacteria and some epithelial cell and lymphocyte and still red blood cell. We also do the abdominal radiography. There are soft tissue opacity outside the abdominal wall size about 28.7 cm. Next is the continue with national.
Okay. Let's talk about the blood examination. From the CBC result, you can see that the dam has sign of leukocytosis and neutrophilia with the trip. And dam has sign of hemoglobin count was decreased and also MCV was slightly decreased. About the RDW was increased. About the platelet, you can see that down show sign of thrombocytosis and about the platelet was also increased. From the serum biochemistry, you can see that ALP, creatinine and thrombopoietin was decreased, but ALT was increased. From the differential diagnosis, you can see that they have the 6 differential diagnosis, but from physical examination, but examination, X-ray and ultrasound, we can rule out 5 of differential diagnosis, that is abscess. We rule out by didn't find any localized accumulation of heart in mental abdomen in the of the duct, and we can rule out the hematoma from didn't find any localized condition of extra but was related but in mental abdomen. And also we also rule out cyst from didn't find any abnormal culture with the little sac in mental abdomen from the X-ray and ultrasound result. And we also rule out the hernia and tumor because of we didn't see any of any abnormal organ in mental abdomen and physical examination we didn't find any structure like tumor in mental abdomen of the duct. So the tentative diagnosis was soft tissue seroma. So we give the treatment plan. That is, we give the amoxicillin chorionic acid dose 8.75 mg per kilogram for 7 days. And we also give the flunisin meconine dose is 2.2 mg per kilogram for 5 days. And we also give the fluid DNA and after that we do the dairy wound dressing. You can see that we did the breed and breed in day 3. So after in day 1, we need a routine monitoring in every day. You can see in 3 p.m. the dam has show sign of tachycardia and hyperthermia. And CBC result is 3 seconds. In 9 p.m., dam also show sign of tachycardia and tachycardia. In day 2, we also give the antibiotic and NSAID. But and we also do the routine monitoring in every day. In 8 a.m., you can see that dam show sign of tachycardia and CRT was 3 seconds, but the temperature in 3 periods of time, that is 8 a.m., 4 p.m., and 10 p.m., was were back to normal. But heart rate and respiration rate was increased. In day 3, in the 8 a.m., Dan also show sign of tachycardia and also sign of increased CRT. And we also do the pre-dentist around 8 a.m. So in 4 p.m., Dan also show sign of weakness and tachycardia. And we have been color also pale. And at 10 p.m., Dan still show sign of depressed and tachycardia. From the blood examination in day 3, you can see that the white blood cell count and neutrophil count decreased significantly but also higher than normal. So we can interpret that Dan also still have leukocytosis and neutrophilia. But you can see that Dan didn't have any bad neutrophil. About the hemoglobin count, you can see that Dan still has decreased hemoglobin count, slightly decreased MCV, and also increased IDW. From the platelet count, you can see that Dan still has sign of thrombocytosis, and fibrinogen was increased to 600 mg per deciliter, and still has the platelet smear was increased.
Okay, next is a fluid drainage procedure. First, we have to shave the fur off of the working area and then scrub with alcohol, thermoclean, and last layer, we'll dab a chlorinolamine. Next, we use the surgical blade to step at the abdominal mass to drain fluid. In this step, we need to keep a restraint tightly. Unfortunately, during the procedure, we accidentally stepped on a blood vessel at in, so that our blood came out with fluid. Next, we have to press around the mask gently to drain the remaining fluid in the mask. Then use a finger palpation inside the mask to find leak of abdominal wall, but in this case, we cannot find any leakage. Then grab gauze of chlorhexidine with forceps and insert it to scrub inside the mask. After that, interpret the right normal saline inside the wound to clean it or remove blood clot. In synchronization step, we insert a gauze soaked with chlorinolamine inside the mask until it fulfills. Last step is spray chlorinolamine around the wound with Necasan to prevent the insect. And we plan to change stitolize and dressing the wound daily. After the procedure, Dan was weakened, so we supported Dan with a sling and fluid therapy used a separate pipe. For the follow-up of Dan, we collect the blood sample to do the blood examination in day 9 and day 11. The result of complete blood count in day 11 or 10 September, compared with previous blood exam and reference range, Dan still found leukocytosis, neutrophilia, and lymphocytosis. And we also found decreased red blood cell, PCB, and hemoglobin that indicated anemia. And we found slightly decreased MCV, increased RDW, and increased reticulocyte or reticulocytosis that indicated regenerative anemia. The dam also found thrombocytosis and decreased plasma protein. The platelet smear was increased, and we also found the abnormal morphology of red blood cell anisocytosis, macrocyte, polychromasia, hypochromasia, and sclerocyte. For the serum biochemistry, we found decreased ALP, decreased creatinine, and decreased total protein. Updated on day 11 or 10 September, Dan was bright, alert, and responsive. It has a normal appetite, defecation, and urination. The womb size and the floors decreased without passing any or bowel odor. For the discussion about the possible cause of Dan's seroma, it can occur by two major factors. First is a prolonged compression from sleep and ventral abdomen that blocks the circulation of blood vessel or lymphatic vessel, so the fluid will congest and accumulation, then it can cause a soft tissue seroma, and it combined with a bacterial infection from infected wound or local infection and pretens placenta or systemic infection from the history taking. These factors can cause a bacterial infection inside the seroma. We suggest to perform a bacterial culture and drug sensitivity test to choose a proper antimicrobial drug. And we should supply local anesthesia before sterilization to reduce pain for animals. And should perform a fecal examination for screening internal parasite infestation. This is our reference. We special thanks for our lovely teacher that gave us not only knowledge, clinical skill, but also good support. Thank you for your attention. If you have any